Hello boys and girls, and welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to Just Shake or Stir. My name is George, and of course it's time for a cocktail. We're gonna go to another classic cocktail today, as you've seen from the title, but of course with a little riff, because plenty videos out there on making the classic Manhattan. So today I'm gonna prepare for you outtake Manhattan, which is a version of the Manhattan, not much changing apart from the maraschino or the cherry flavor here. It's taking a little bit bigger part than just being a garnish. And I presume most of you will love this version because I know few of you like cherry a lot, like me. So boys and girls, if you're ready, if you want to see this lovely, kind of a, on the sweet side drift of the classic Manhattan, sit down nicely, relax. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget, you can subscribe to don't miss any other recipes, homemade ingredients, and whatever else come related to the mixology. But for now, let's make the cocktail which it's called Outtake Manhattan. So boys and girls, the first recipe or the first kind of a record of Manhattan, I think it's, as far I know, it's recorded back in 1891. By a chap called William Schmidt, and I think the book is called The Flowing Bowl. I think so. Now, the recipe, it's a very, you know, the old style school written. So it says around 2 dashes of bitter, 2 dashes of gome syrup, which is, you know, Arabic gome syrup, a dash of absinthe, which is strange because we know the absinthe is gone now from the Manhattan. And obviously you have the whiskey and the vino aperitivo or vermouth. Over the years, the absinthe is gone, the gome is gone. The maraschino, also it's mentioned there that you can add a little bit of maraschino liqueur, maraschino, maraschino, whatever you know it, you know what I mean, but slowly became a garnish till, as we know, the version today. And in the original recipe, it says whiskey, and we all know a slowly evolve to become a bourbon, which is the main spirit used. However, you can use any whiskey, I presume back in the days, because you know it's coming like from New York. New York was a heavy use on rye whiskey, so could be that the situation what it was originally slowly turned to a bourbon. But of course, there's still, till these days, versions with the whiskey, or even some places people prefer it with Tennessee or Canadian whiskey. Also, if we talk about the method of making a Manhattan, of course, it's stirred, and you know, it's served in martini glass or a cold chill glass, and that's how we know it. But there's nothing wrong to serve it over ice if you want to be, you know, a little bit diluted, if you prefer drinking drinks over ice. And of course, in an old-fashioned glass. But if I have to mention before I make the recipe, if I have to mention the three probably most iconic Manhattans which you maybe should try before you do any riffs, this is the sweet Manhattan, which is with Martini Rosso. There's a dry Manhattan, which is with a dry Martini. And there's the perfect Manhattan, as people call it, which is with equal part of dry Martini and sweet Vermouth, okay? Or a dry Vermouth, I don't know why I'm mentioning Martini. It doesn't have to be Martini. It's just dry or sweet Vermouth. Okay, but today we're gonna make this beauty, which is Outtake Manhattan. So in this recipe, what we're gonna need? We're gonna need a cherry brandy or a cherry herring for this Manhattan. Now, that's what I mentioned earlier, that the actual cherry here, the cherry flavor is not just the garnish, but it's taking a little bit more part in the cocktail. Of course, we need a sweet vermouth, which I'm gonna grab from my fridge. It's nice and cool. And of course, the main ingredients, we need a bourbon. So I'm gonna use a buffalo trace. I do love the buffalo trace. Let me just put them here so you see what we have. Have the buffalo trace bourbon, which is gonna be the base of the cocktail. As a Manhattan, we have obviously the Vermouth Rosso, but we adding the cherry herring or a cherry brandy if you have, whatever you prefer. And of course, finally, but not last, Angostura bitter. The fact here, originally it was used orange bitter, but slowly just moved to Angostura bitter. And this is how things happen, you know, I mean, things changing over time, and something which was created one way, it just became totally different. Anyway, let's make the cocktail. We're gonna stir. So first, I'm gonna start with my bourbon. And we're gonna go with 60 ml of Buffalo Trace, which is 2 ounces. This is gonna be followed by 50 ml or 1/2 ounce of cherry herring or cherry brandy. Whatever you have at home, use it. This is gonna give this lovely cherry flavor and a little bit more fruitiness to the cocktail. Next, we're gonna have a 30 ml of Vermouth Rosso. I like to use Vermouth di Torino. And finally, 2-3 dashes of Angostura bitter. And that's it. Now we need ice, we're gonna stir the cocktail and we're gonna serve. I'm going to serve in a chilled martini glass. So I need a little ice, but not very little. When you stir, make sure you put enough ice because you don't want to put few cubes and dilute the cocktail quick. Because you're stirring, so you're giving a little bit more time to ice to melt, so you don't want, you know, I mean, to put a little bit of ice and dilute too much the cocktail. And while I'm stirring, don't forget, you can subscribe and click this small bell on the side to get notified every week for a new video. I may start doing 2 videos a week, I don't know yet. Right. Oh, that's wonderful. Just a strain, a normal strain, not double because it's no shaken. So just a little straight away in the martini glass. Beautiful. Now if you're fancy, you can use a orange peel to express and discard. You don't need to put orange peel inside. For me, I kind of like the cherry and I don't want to take away from it. So what I'm going to do is just gonna drop a maraschino cherry inside with little bit of the syrup. There you go. And this is gonna be kind of a my treat on the end when I finish the cocktail, just to have a nice bite of the maraschino cherry. And this is it, boys and girls. This is the cocktail called Outtake Manhattan. It's more on the sweet side, like I said, because you have the cherry herring or cherry brandy if you use. But it's a fantastic sip and a wonderful variation of the classic Manhattan. So let's just have a quick test. Ooh-hoo-hoo. Yes, you have the kick from the bourbon. You have this wonderful herbal flavor from the vermouth. And of course, the very good presence of cherry because of the cherry herring. Even though the cherry herring is sweet, and you have the sweet vermouth because it's a double measure here of like a double shot of bourbon. It's strong enough to overpower this sweetness and kind of a balance really nice everything with especially with the help of the Angostura bitter. So not far from the classic Manhattan, apart from being a little bit more on the sweet side and more kind of on the cherry side, which is fantastic, wonderful sip. Okay, this is it from me, guys. I'm gonna leave you now and I'll see you next week with another cocktail. Until then, as always, stay safe and I love you and I leave you now. Bye-bye.